Hi guys, I'm Randy, and in this week's Reef to Reef FAQ, we're answering questions from last week's BRS TV Spotlight video on the Neptune System's Leak Detection Kit, or LDK. Our first question is from Kai Pax Press on YouTube, who asks, are the probes single use? This is a great question that really helps to drive home the maintenance recommendations we provided in the video. The leak detection probes are multi-use sensors that use sealed metal contacts under the probe to detect when water's present. Basically, if water crosses from one contact to another, it will close the circuit and send a signal to your apex that the switch is closed. It is this signal that sends you an email or text alert when water isn't where it's supposed to be. With that in mind, maintaining the contacts on the bottom of the probe is always a good idea to ensure your sensors will work when it matters most. The next question is from Frank Cava, who asks, how often do they update the firmware? Although Neptune doesn't have a set schedule for when updates are sent out, they do seem to be available about every few months or so. Once you download a new full firmware update, you'll want to check the modules page to see if any of them now require one as well. For the Apex Junior and Apex Classic, you can update the firmware from the Apex Fusion page, but you will have to access the local IP page to do any updates to the modules individually. As for the latest Neptune Apex, you can find any module updates under the Modules tab and by clicking on the modules with the caution indicator. Finally, Cliff Shepard on YouTube asks, is there any way to run two modules? My display is upstairs and the sump is in the basement. Another solid question, Cliff, and a common concern for many reefers with remote fish rooms or multiple tanks throughout the house. For folks just like you, Neptune Systems does have longer versions of the Aquabus cables available in 15-foot and 30-foot lengths. Along with that, they also have extension cables that you can use to link multiple cables together. Just keep in mind that you can have up to 200 feet of Aquabus cable per system, and it's recommended to at least have one powered accessory, like a one link or an energy bar, every 75 feet. Well guys, that does it for today's Reef to Reef FAQ, and thank you so much for the questions and comments. You can find a new BRS TV Spotlight video every week on the Reef to Reef BRS sponsor page, so be sure to chime in if there's anything more you want to know. See you tomorrow with the next Spotlight video where we explore the Tunzi Osmolator 3155 ATO.